Now, in continuation with our discussion for proportionate input tax credit to be disallowed in case of taxable and exempt or business and non-business supplies, another provision is regarding banking company or a financial institution, including non-banking financial company NBFC, engaged in accepting deposits and extending loans or advances. So in short, it is specifically for banking and NBFC, non-banking financial corporations or institutions. They are having an option instead of going for the detailed calculation, right? So what is that option? Option to follow any one method. The first method is either comply with the provision of section 7 subsection 2, as we have just discussed, entire calculation for inputs and input services and capital goods on proportionate basis, they can calculate and add to output tax liability, like D1 and D2 in case of inputs, input services and for capital goods. And if they don't want to go by the detailed calculation, then a simple method is also given, or comply with provisions of section 17(4). There is a simple provision given under section 17 subsection 4. They can comply with this. So the requirement of that is either they can opt first option or second option. But when they can use this option, at the beginning of their in between, can they change it in between, etc. So the option once exercised shall not be withdrawn during the remaining part of the financial year. So a particular bank decided to go by the second option of 50%, that is a simpler option, then they cannot change that option again back to option 1 during that particular financial year. They have to wait for the completion of financial year. In the next financial year, again they can exercise option number 1. Again for entire year, continue with option 1. If they want, they can switch to second option in the next accounting financial year. The restriction of 50%, we are going to discuss this, the calculation. The restriction of 50% shall not apply to tax paid on supplies made by one registered person to another registered person having same permanent account number. So as you are aware that a bank will have lot many branches in various different states, probably, right? So from one branch to another branch, if they are providing any services, since the branch is in a different state, it will be a different taxable entity. It will be treated as a supply, and on that GST will be charged. So the receiving branch will enjoy input tax credit for that supply, right? So we can say that it is inter-branch transactions of a bank, of supply of any services or might be of goods also. So in such cases, the restriction of 50% is not applicable. So think from the point of view of, say, there is one branch in Mumbai who is receiving services from Delhi branch. So from Mumbai branch point of view, the input services received from Delhi branch are eligible for input tax credit at 100%, irrespective of whether ultimately these services will be utilized for exempt taxable supplies by Mumbai branch or not. The inter-branch transactions are 100% eligible. This 50% calculation is not applicable on that. We will see how to calculate by the 50% methodology under second option now. The formula is as under: total input tax credit for the month. Now here for banks, there is no bifurcation in inputs and input services and capital goods. The ad hoc or overall method for all is given. So input tax credit for the month includes input tax credit on inputs, capital goods and input services, all. Take the total of that. From that deduct, the first one is ITC not allowed under section 17(5). This is quite logical and similar to the discussion of our previous method also. Those input tax credit which are not at all allowed under GST, like beauty or health club treatment, etc. These are to be removed, whether they are used for business or not, whether they are used for supplying taxable, non-taxable services, etc. They are any which way disallowed, so remove them. That is number one. Number two, input tax credit or inter-branch supply. As just now we discussed that if Mumbai branch is receiving supply from Delhi branch, this is something input tax credit or inter-branch supply. This also for the time being you remove, because it will be eligible for 100% input tax credit. That we will consider later on in the calculation. So for the time being remove this. So whatever balance amount of input tax credit is remaining, on that ITC for the month will be 50% of balance in above calculation, right? So that will be calculation A. Let us call it as 50% of balance ITC, call it as A. Now, as we have discussed, ITC on inter-branch supply is 100% allowed under this method. So we should add this for eligible input tax credit, right? So let us call it as ITC on inter-branch supply is B. So total ITC will be A plus B. A was the amount of 50% plus B is inter-branch supply. So total ITC will be A plus B. Now you must have got why we have deducted this in upper calculation half, because this has to be removed. It was eligible for 100%. It was eligible 100%. So we have removed it. Only the balance ITC is considered for 50% of the calculation. Let us try to understand this with one example now. Say total ITC for the month for one particular branch was 1 lakh rupees. ITC on inputs and input services used for non-business purpose, there might be some kind of non-business activities done by the branch of that bank. So ITC on that was 4000 rupees. ITC not allowed under section 17(5) is 500, and ITC on inter-branch supply is 1000. So now this particular branch is having two options. Option number one is, as per section 17(2), they can go for that detailed calculation for month-to-month basis, right? Or else directly pay 50% and 100% on ITC for inter-branch supply. So if this bank goes for second option, let us see what will be the calculation. So the starting point is total ITC for the period. So total ITC for the month, including inputs, capital goods, input services, is given as rupees 1 lakh. Now second is ITC not allowed under section 17(5). That we have to remove. This is readily given. ITC not allowed under section 17(5) is 500. And third one, ITC on inter-branch supply 1000. So ITC on inter-branch supply 1000 is also reduced, right? So from 1 lakh, these two amounts are reduced. We get balance ITC of 98,500. Now here you will make a point that input tax credit on inputs used for non-business purpose, why we are not considering? Because it is nowhere in our formula, right? If you are using the first method, then only you have to apply this particular factor in the calculation. But for this second way of calculation, this particular factor is not at all there in the formula. We are ignoring that. So balance ITC is 98,500. On this, it will have 50% input tax credit eligible. So 50% of 98,500 will be 49,250. And for balance ITC of inter-branch supply, entire ITC is allowed. So that 1000 is entirely added back again over here. So total ITC will be equal to A plus B, that is 50% on other input tax credit and 1000 of inter-branch supply. So total input tax credit will be 50,250, that is eligible for for this particular branch.